Anderson? What are you doing here? I didn't send...
Let's go. Get us out of here, Joker. Now.
This is your Goofy Uncle GreatTreeJam, and I want to welcome you back to another episode of Mass Effect 1. So we finally escaped the Citadel's lockdown, and we are now in space. Unfortunately, we are also fugitives running from the Alliance and from Citadel authorities. But I believe that the important thing is that we need to stop Saren, because if he finds the Conduit and manages to bring back the Reapers, the galaxy will stand no chance. They will be overrun, and everything we know will be destroyed. So let's open up the galaxy map, and we're going to get set up for the final push in Mass Effect 1. We are now in the end run, ladies and gents. So let's get out of the Citadel, and we're going to leave the Serpent Nebula. Our final stop is going to be the Pangaea Expanse, and we're going to be headed to the Refuge System where we will find Ilos. Let's get to it, folks. And here we are in the Refuge System. Let's talk about the planet of Akatatan. There's nothing of interest for us here. We have no items that we can scan, no resources we can collect, but we can know that this was an area where the Prothean seems to have several aerostat colonies, all of which appear to be either derelict or destroyed. Well, let's go ahead and zoom out, and we're going to stop off at the planet of Zaf, or Zafe, or Zafe. Not sure how you say that. Besides the previous Helium-3 operations that may have taken place a long time ago, there is nothing of interest for us here. And that's pretty much it. Our final stop is going to be the planet of Ilos, or rather I should say our penultimate stop. We're going to be returning to the Citadel for the end run, but let's go ahead and get set for our planetary drop on Ilos. This is a point of no return, ladies and gentlemen. At this point, we've already denied our ability to use the Citadel docks. We can no longer use the vendors on the Citadel. We can no longer meander around the Citadel as we would normally. We are pretty much in the end run, and once we head to Ilos, everything is dedicated towards the ending. You will not be able to finish any assignments. So, let's go ahead and get set up for the final push in Mass Effect 1. In the golden age of the Protheans, Ilos was a verdant world, dotted with the spires and arches of magnificent cities. Even casual observation shows this is no longer the case. Ilos has been devastated by means unknown, its entire surface changed to the color of rust. The atmosphere shows heightened levels of oxygen. Wildfires, presumably ignited by lightning strikes, can be seen burning on the dark side. This indicates that most, if not all, respirating animal life forms have died off. Surface gravity is a comfortable 1.17 standard Gs. And here we're going to find Saren, who seems to be searching for the Conduit. We still don't understand what it is, but we do know that it is key to the return of the Reapers. So we need to get on the surface and see if we can put a stop to Saren indefinitely.
Shepard, may I speak with you?
And before we continue, folks, if you do have a current relationship with any of your squad mates, you're going to be consummating that relationship here.
I was just thinking about you.
I have been thinking about you too, and what we are about to face. I do not know what is going to happen on Ilos. I hope we will stop Saren, of course, but part of me fears we are already too late. There is something I must tell you, in case we fail.
We're not going to fail. I promise.
Please, I am not looking for comfort. Saren might already have the Conduit. It is time to be completely honest with each other. These could be our last moments together. Our last chance to show each other how we feel. I want this to be special.
We don't have to do this. Not unless you're sure.
I have never been more sure of anything in my life. Will you join with me, Shepard? Let our bodies and minds unite.
Just tell me what to do.
By the goddess. That was incredible, Shepard.
Ready for round two?
Commander?
5 minutes ETA to the Mew relay.
I had better go. Duty calls. You would not want to keep Joker waiting. Shepard, whatever happens on Ilos, I just wanted to say thank you for everything.
Commander? We've got company.
Have the sensors picked us up yet?
Well, stealth systems are engaged. Unless we get close enough for a visual, they won't have any idea we're here.
Picking up some strange readings from the planet's surface.
Take us down, Joker. Lock in on the coordinates.
Negative on that, Commander. The nearest landing zone's 2 clicks away.
We'll never make it in time on foot. Get us something closer.
There is nowhere closer. I've looked!
Drop us in the Mako.
You need at least 100 meters of open terrain to pull off a drop like that. The most I can find near Saren is 20.
20 meters? We'll never get in close enough for a drop.
We have to try.
Find another landing zone.
There is no other landing zone!
The descent angle's too steep.
It's our only option.
It's not an option, it's a suicide run. We don't...
I can do it.
Joker?
I can do it.
Gear up and head down to the Mako. Joker, drop us right on top of that bastard.
All right, folks, we've got a beat on Saren. We're going to pull off a risky drop. It's not going to be one to... It's going to be easy for us. But we're going to take Liara to Sony along with us because she does have some dialogue when we finally encounter a certain Prothean artifact. And we have to bring along Erdnot Rex. I think Rex is going to want some payback after what happened on Vermeer. So without further ado, folks, this is our final squad for the rest of the game. We are pretty much set up for the ending of Mass Effect 1. Let's get over planet side.
We have to get inside this bunker before Saren finds the conduit. There is no way we're getting past that door with brute force.
Saren found some way to open it. There must be some kind of security override somewhere in this complex.
We will have to find some way to get it up and running again.
Aw, he closed a door on us. How cute. Well, we can't use the Mako for this particular segment unless you really want to. You could certainly use a gun, but we're gonna need to move back here. And before I forget, let me go ahead and just quickly equip some gear for me and my squad mates. And I'm probably not going to cut this out. I really should go for infernal rounds, but I also feel like it's going to give me too much of an advantage, so let's make it a little bit harder on us and go with Sledgehammer. And let me go ahead and get some energized plating and a medical exoskeleton. And we'll do the same for Liara. And Rex already has plenty of regeneration ability, but I do think I want to speed it along by adding a medical exoskeleton for him as well. And I'm going to go ahead and have him outfitted with some frictionless materials. And once again, gonna challenge myself not to use infernal rounds this time. And I believe, folks, we are pretty much set. Oh crap, hang on. Yeah. I can't fire my gun for some reason. That's not normal. Okay, let's try this. Alright, we're gonna push forward right here. We're gonna see if we can get the Geth to fall back a bit. And I believe Rex and Liara are kind of stuck behind cover. Alright, it wasn't too smooth, but we managed to pull that one off. Alright, let me go ahead and get a little lift going right here. We're gonna keep moving up. Oh, I see what's going on here. Hang on. Let me go ahead and have Rex put on a little immunity. And I think we're gonna have to fall back because up ahead behind us, we're gonna find a couple of Geth armatures. I don't think we want to engage them just yet. Yeah, I think Rex is glitched out right now. Okay, I'm not quite sure what was happening with Rex there and Liara. Okay, folks, I'm gonna go ahead and do this. I'm gonna try and pull Liara and Rex out of combat. Okay, could've done that earlier, but what a buzzkill. I really hate it when they do that. It just completely kills the flow, completely kills my mood when that happens. Alright, well, let's go ahead and move forward now. Now, looks like we have one Geth right here. Alright, there we go. Got a shock trooper right here. Alright. And we have an armature. We need to get our overload going there. And I think I'm gonna go ahead and get some warp going while Liara gets her lift on. Okay, that was one hell of a hit. Liara is about to go down, so we're gonna run this way. And I'm gonna use sabotage here. Okay. Normally this is a very dangerous strategy to pursue, but I believe we're certainly powerful enough to withstand this, so. And there we go. That's one reason I wanted to retreat back here, is because of those two armatures. I didn't want them closing in on the squad mates and us getting sandwiched between the Geth. That's pretty much a death sentence on insanity, unless you're really quick, really fast with your trigger finger. But we're gonna head down here. There's still a number of Geth down below, and while we're going down here, we're gonna collect some crates. And take out some Geth along the way. Alright, let's keep moving down, folks. Now there should be some hopper units somewhere around here. Okay, let's see if we can't get them into a little bit of singularity. Okay, and Rex and Liara are centered on an enemy right around here. Another one right here. Alright, and that pretty much not only clears out some of the debris, it's going to make it easier for us to see some of the crates that have gear for us. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at this crate right here. At this point, we're not going to worry about loot as much, and I'm probably going to end up missing some containers here and there, so if you guys are looking for a comprehensive guide, unfortunately this may not be it. At least for Ilos and beyond, I'm not going to care so much for loot collection, because we've already gotten the best loot that we can. Nonetheless, if I do see some loot, you know, I will make an attempt to at least point it out. So, let's go ahead and move it forward, and if you have any trouble with armatures, you can actually head down here, and you can use decryption. And that will deactivate the armatures for you. We can go ahead and deactivate it just because, well, we feel like it. Wasn't even paying attention to the screen when I was doing that. You know you're at a special level of achievement when you get to that, when you can just hold down the trigger and not look at the screen. Oh, it's amazing. But I believe that is pretty much everything that we care about down here, or at least that I care about. We're gonna head up the stairs, and now we're gonna see if we can enter the facility. We still have a little bit of ground to cover. Not a whole lot left, but we do still have plenty of Geth along the way that will try and stop us. But the hardest part for the exterior portion is done. So, we're gonna head up here, and I'm gonna take a quick look around the corner and see if there's anything of value. Just these statues right here. You, sir, are not getting any dates. I'm sorry. And now we're gonna move this way. And here we're approaching the courtyard that we were fighting the two armatures in. We're actually not going to be able to use the elevator over here. Our goal is actually going to take us past the elevator and down this alley right here. But let's go ahead and grab the crate, get whatever loot we can, I'm gonna go ahead and switch to on-gel for now. And we're gonna keep moving on. It looks like pretty much everything on the planet is dead, save for the Geth. And we can go ahead and move around here. I believe there's going to be one position that I'm going to want to make use of once I find it. Here we go. Right about here, we actually have two ways that we can go. We can keep going this way, or we can actually take advantage of something right here. There's actually an opportunity to get the drop on some Geth in this area. I'm going to move up here. And we're going to go ahead and throw a little singularity there. There we go. We've taken care of the Geth in this little area. Let's go ahead and move back now. We're actually not going to have to stay here. So let's keep moving forward, and we still have yet to find Saren. So let's remember that he has a head start on us, so we've got quite a bit of ground to make up. A lot of lost ground to... Oh, hello. Yep, I think I know what Liara was shooting at. I believe there are at least one or two shock troopers on the balcony right here. Let's go ahead and get them with a little singularity field. Alright, and that shock trooper is down. Before we go up this elevator and try and grab what's on the balcony, I'm going to go ahead and clear out the Geth in this area. We've taken care of some of the ground troops, but we still have a bunch of hoppers around. So all I have to do is move forward right about here, and turn right, and we should be in about this area. The courtyard's where we took out the destroyer and several other troopers, and I think maybe some shock troopers? I don't remember. I've already forgotten. Oh, wow. Okay, let's do this. Let's go ahead and get a little immunity up, because I got a bad feeling about this. Alright, I think we're going to need to be careful. Alright, come on. Come on, buddy. Okay, here we go. And there we go. Let's go ahead and run back this way. I'm gonna go ahead and open up the elevator real quick, and oh, you already guys are inside. Perfect. And we're gonna head up and grab some loot on the balcony. Like I said, I will try to make an effort to grab some loot, but grabbing every single piece of loot that I encounter at this point is no longer a priority for me. I'm doing this to see whether or not I can get any last minute rare items that are shiny and attract my eye. But other than that, there is no need for us to worry, obsess too much over loot. So, sorry for you guys that want a more in-depth guide on how to collect every single container on Ilos, but if you want, I recommend that you check out the wiki online, the Mass Effect wiki, and I believe you can get some pointers there as to where you can find the loot containers. I just want to move on at this point. I wonder, can I actually go up here? No, I cannot.
I never dreamed I would actually find Ilos. I wish I had more time to study all of this. So much history here, so much to learn. I only hope I have the chance to come back someday. I never dreamed I would actually find Ilos.
And since Liara is with us, and she is our xenoarchaeologist, she is absolutely nerding out right now. Rex, however, is much more, you know, the stalwart warrior.
A lot of people died here long ago. Now it's time for a lot of Geth to join them.
So his comments are going to be centered around the history of bloodshed in this place.
There's something in the air here. Death is on the wind. It's a good place for killing. A lot of people died here long ago. Now it's time for a lot of Geth to join them.
And we can go ahead and keep moving up. Nothing that I'm really interested in here. But let's go ahead and move on. I do want to get down to the control area where the controls are for the door. So let's go ahead and board the elevator. And we've got a few more Geth to fight through on foot here.
This place still has power. It must be running off its own generator.
This must be the command center for the entire complex. Saren's troops must have sealed the doors from here after he went inside. We will have to figure out how to disengage the security lockdown if we ever want to get inside that bunker.
Alright. Let me go ahead and switch up to a sniper real quick. And I'm gonna have Liara and Rex wait right here. We're gonna want to move up very carefully. As it turns out, there are a number of hostile Geth that are just lying in wait in the distance. Alright, if we can take him down, then it's gonna be one less Geth we have to worry about. Oh. He pretty much is down. Alright. Alright, let's see if we can get a beat on another Geth. Oh. Oh. I think we have ourselves a Geth Prime. These guys are particularly dangerous to fight because not only do they have incredible firepower and they all seem to work very well in groups, they can also use tech abilities against us. So a lot of the abilities that we have, they can actually utilize against our squad, so we gotta be careful. So let's go ahead and just chip away this Geth Prime's health, bit by bit. Shouldn't take much longer, hopefully. And there we go, Geth Prime is down. We still have a few more units left up ahead, so we gotta be careful. Right, and they've got the beat on us. Alright, and that should be the end of that shock trooper right there. Alright, let's see, any more? Oh, hello. Okay. Shock Trooper is down. Okay, I think we're ready to engage at close quarters. There may be a Juggernaut around here. Or not, maybe not a Juggernaut, but at least a Destroyer. Yep, a Destroyer. Let's go ahead and get some Singularity going. We're gonna go ahead and get lift on this guy. And there we go. And that should be every single hostile in the area. Hey, what's up, buddy? How's it going? You're dead. And we can move on. Now, we can actually utilize the balcony up here, but given the AoE attacks of the Geth Prime, I personally don't recommend it. You're probably going to be spending more time being frustrated up here, but in any case, you will have a lot more cover. My personal strategy for if you're fighting against these guys and you're having a little bit of trouble, try and utilize the area back there to snipe if you are a sniper. And see if you can engage each Geth one-on-one. Other than that, make use of biotics and you should be pretty good. But let's go ahead and move up. We have a number of consoles we can actually utilize. This is one more tip. If you're actually in the middle of the fray, you can go ahead and hack these terminals, and these armatures will fight for you. You're so cute and cuddly. I'm gonna call you Fluffy. Actually, no, I'm not, but you get the point. It's kind of cute just watch these things stand around. We don't need to do this, but I think I like them. They're like little pets that you buy at stores that are made of metal and shoot things. Yeah. How's it going? Hey, Timmy. And we're gonna keep moving up. Oh, wait, hold on a second. There's two more. Actually, let's go ahead and get this one right here. Right behind us. And another one right here. Just because I feel like it. And that's another way that you can actually get some help. You can get the armatures to fight off any Geth that are attacking you. But for now, we're pretty much running short on time with regards to Saren, so we need to keep moving. Let's keep our eyes open for one crate that I'm going to grab. Everything else I'm probably going to end up disregarding for now. So let's keep our eyes open, and I believe the crate is right here. Let's go ahead and just decrypt this real quick with Omnigel. And there we go. And now I've got an excuse to melt down all these excess items that I'm collecting into Omnigel. But pretty much, that's it. We're done with the on-foot combat, unless we want to fight outside the Mako for the upcoming portion. But let's go ahead and open the security panel, and we're going to unlock those doors.
Come, Saren already has a head start. We have to go find him before he reaches the conduit.
Unless he's already found it, then we're just walking into a trap.
That is a chance we will have to take.
Hold on. Something's happening.
Too late. Unable to... Invading fleets. No escape.
Sounds like some kind of message, but I don't recognize the language.
It is probably in Prothean. This recording must be 50,000 years old. No wonder we cannot understand it.
The message is all broken up, but I recognize some of the words. It's a warning against the Reaper invasion.
Of course. Between the beacons and the cipher, an understanding of the Prothean language would have been transferred into your mind.
Not safe. Seek refuge. Inside the archives.
What's it saying? Can you make out anything useful?
Old Reapers. The Citadel. Overwhelmed. Only hope.
Act of desperation. The conduit. All is lost.
It said something about the conduit, but it's too degraded to help. We should go.
Cannot be stopped. Cannot be stopped.
This is one part of the game where you get an appreciation for how serious things must have been for the Protheans. The Reapers really pose a real threat, and once you get to Ilos, I feel that if it hasn't already gotten dark enough for you, the game gets extremely dark here. We're wandering around the remains of a civilization that was wiped out by the Reapers, possibly one of the worst genocides within galactic history. And the only thing that we can do is wander around and pick up the clues and see if we can avoid the same fate that the Protheans met 50,000 years ago. This, folks, is pretty grim. And unfortunately, it seems that we're facing the same fate the Protheans are. We need to find Saren, and we need to discover what the conduit really is. And if it is indeed a weapon, we need to put a stop to it. Ideally, we'd like to be able to utilize it and use it against the Reapers, but for now, let's go ahead and put that at the back of our minds and stay focused on getting back towards the gate where Saren went through. And let's not do that, Shepard. We're gonna let the armatures, leave the armatures there. Mommy's gonna leave the house, and they're not gonna throw any crazy parties. And one thing I really love about the music in this area, it's really dark and really tense. And I like that a lot about Ilos. But let's go ahead and move forward. Here we've actually just emerged from the elevator that we passed earlier. The only thing left for us is to head this way and get geared up for the final portion of Ilos right here. Because we are now level 60, we no longer have to worry about experience penalties from fighting within the Mako. So we're going to use the Mako for the remainder of this Ilos segment.
Take the vehicle into the creepy underground bunker.
Good idea. Firepower will come in handy.
You read my line, Liara. Alright, let's go ahead and move in. And while we're moving down here, we can actually get an idea what's actually inside the archives.
I have spent my life studying the Protheans, but I never dreamed I would discover anything like this. This bunker might have been the last refuge of their entire species. Just imagine what mysteries it might hold. Imagine what secrets it might reveal.
Hey, try to remember why we're here. Saren, the conduit, the fate of the entire known galaxy.
I am sorry. I was swept up in the moment. I just hope we have the opportunity to study this place in detail after this is done.
I thought Saren would have set some kind of trap or ambush for us. They must have been in too much of a hurry.
Or we just have yet to run into it.
So a lot of dialogue there. Sometimes if you're just charging forward, you may miss the exposition from your squad mates. So every time I'm going to try and pause a vehicle just long enough to hear what my squad mates are saying. But here we're actually inside the Prothean archives, and we're seeing a lot of stasis pods around. I think it's going to become pretty clear what this area was designated for. But I'm going to go ahead and keep quiet on that for now, and we're just going to keep moving up. From here on out, all combat, except for when we leave Ilos, will be in the Mako. So let's go ahead and move up.
What are all those things on the wall? Some kind of containers?
They look like stasis pods. The Protheans probably tried to keep themselves alive through cryogenic freezing. Something must have gone wrong. This bunker became their tomb. The pods are dead as well as anyone inside.
All of them? There must be hundreds of those pods. What was Saren expecting to find here? There's nothing left but corpses.
It seems that way. Alright, and it seems that we do have some hostiles in the distance. I'm gonna go ahead and engage them with the Mako's main cannon. And we're gonna keep moving up. And we've actually noticed that the music has taken a bit more of a, I guess you can say, slightly, I don't want to say cheerier tone, but definitely kind of a, it's a lot less dark in tone than the earlier music that was playing when we were at the control center for Ilos. Well, let's keep moving up. We still have a little bit of ground to cover. At this point, all we're doing is taking in the sights and getting an idea, getting a feel for the place that the Protheans have built. It seems this area was meant for trying to preserve the Protheans, and I'm guessing that they started to realize what the Reapers really were, but unfortunately this facility did not save them.
What is happening?
It's a trap! Saren must have set an ambush.
I do not think Saren is behind this.
Alright. The only thing left for us is try and get out on foot. We're actually going to head down this way, and we're actually going to experience one of my favorite moments of Mass Effect 1. But before we do anything else, I do feel that this recording has gone on long enough, so I'm going to have to end the recording here. And next time we pick up, we're actually going to be meeting... I don't want to spoil it too much for you guys. Let's just say this. We're going to be interfacing with a certain Prothean artifact, and I believe that this is one of the very... I'm completely just slaughtering my speech right now, but this is one particular moment that really got me invested in Mass Effect 1. Let me go ahead and make a save. And I mean really invested. And I want to go ahead and call it quits here. Alright, this is Great Tree Gems. I want to wish you guys a happy day, night, evening, afternoon, wherever you may be in this universe or the next, and I hope to see you in my next vid. We're going to find out exactly what is responsible for these energy barriers, and we're going to find out a lot more about the Reapers and the Protheans' plans, but until then, I want to bid you guys farewell. Bye.